I'm installing the automatic tool changer on the system, and I'm up to the point where I'm aligning the tools. And what I'm seeing is as the spindle is lowering over the tool change position, it's displacing the spindle, the tool holder, in the positive X direction, just a hair. And I'm trying to think what I need to adjust to fix that. The negative, negative, and plus, plus buttons aren't really helping this particular situation, and I'm wondering if maybe I need to tilt the ATC a little, or what you think. So I'm going to show you what's happening with this. Okay, the first thing I'm doing is I'm sending the gonna retract the ATC first out of the way, and I'm gonna go to the tray load position. Okay, so there we are. Now, just to make things interesting, I'm gonna move the tray forward a couple times and then reference it. Okay, that's about as, you know, as random as you can get this. So when I drop the spindle down, now I'm right at the nose. You'll notice it should shift a little bit to one side. So I'm gonna put this in closer, and here we go. I don't know if you could see it shift. So I'm going to retract it. Move the tray load position again. I'm going to repeat it. Okay, here we go. Okay, so I'm not really sure, you know, what to do. So I'm looking for advice. If you guys have any, I'd really appreciate it. Or if you could see that happening, you know, in an exaggerated way, this is the top of the tool holder. It's going over like that slightly as the spindle comes down. So it's like it's catching the upper left edge and pushing it over a little bit. So, you know, loosen up one of the forks. I don't know where to begin with this one. The challenge that I'm dealing with right now is getting the automatic tool changer aligned with the tools. You have to first tilt the automatic tool changer object right here. You have to tilt it back and forth in order to get it level and everything. I've done most of that. Right now, the thing that I have to do is get the spindle to line up with the tool without pushing it one way or the other. And what I've been having a little bit of difficulty with is the tool holder is being displaced in the positive X direction just a bit. So, you know, once I solve this, then it's just a matter of putting the enclosure on this beast and start cutting. So I have to adjust each of these 10 positions on the tool changer. So it's going to be an interesting time. Now there you see, this is the spindle okay? And these are the forks of the automatic tool changer. And I have this collet that I'm gonna place into the forks, and they slip over this metal tang that's right in the middle. Okay, now, this may be difficult to do two-handed, but here we go. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna raise the spindle up a little bit, barrel down. Okay, I'm gonna retract the tray out of the way. And now I'm gonna go to the tool load position, and you'll see the spindle will move up out of the way, and the tray will come in. Now, if I reference the tool tray, it'll go and it'll find its zero. I'm gonna move it a couple places out of position first. Okay, and then hit reference tray. So what it did just then was it went using the sensor to find its extremes, you know, one side or the other in that position. Now theoretically, I am right underneath the spindle, and you know, with any luck, that's the case. But see if you can see it move the tool holder out of position just a little bit as I come down. Okay, it should be happening right about now. Yep, it jumped off to one side. So anyway, that's what I got to figure out, is how to get that little bit of X movement over the thing. I think I probably have to tilt something or other, but I'm not really sure. But it is repeatable, so I was able to get it to happen again. So I'm going to retract the tray, go to the tool load position, and drop down again. All that time it didn't move. Anyway, hey guys, it's Bill. Yesterday we were doing some adjustments to the automatic tool changer and trying to get everything aligned, and we managed to do quite a bit of that today. One of the issues we had was that the tool changer wasn't level, and neither was the mill, even though we had done a little bit of it. So a friend brought over a very good level, and we were able to get that squared away. So pretty cool. Now the last thing that we're doing is adjusting the individual forks on the tool changer. I'll show you what those look like. Now in each one of these positions, you've got two nylon bolts that you have to adjust, and you raise and lower the head the spindle of the mill until it's just above this plastic part of the fork. And there should be a little bit, there's a little bit of backlash in there, but it should clear all the parts. And in this case, you can see that this one does clear. So you have to set that for all 10 of the parts of the tool changer, and that's kind of what we just did. So hopefully that should be most of our issues when we're done with it, and that will allow us to put the enclosure around this thing. So just give you a quick update, and also to remind you that you're almost out of time to enter the 5K giveaway, where we're giving away some t-shirts to the members to celebrate the fact that we've reached 5,000 members. So very happy with the progress that we've been having. So I would hope that if you want to enter that contest, that you just go ahead and go on to cncroutertips.com/enter and put your information in there. I'm going to be, I hope you guys all get a chance to enter. And I can't wait to see it cut either, Richard Harper. So it's very cool. Jesse Houston in the house, Rich Harper. We got lots of good folks on here. Thank you all for watching this. I know it was impromptu and you didn't get a chance to know it was going, but at least you know we're making progress. Jesse wants me to make the Tormach move. Okay, Jess, just for you. Give me a sec. Okay, so I'm going to take the spindle up out of that position. I'm going to retract the tool tray. That's cool. So now I'm going to show you the table, which we've got some things on, and we're going to move the y-axis back away. I'm at about 40% or 50% rapid, so I'm going to crank it up to 100% so you can see the difference. And it also moves left and right. Spindle coming down. We're going to turn the spindle on to about 2000 RPM. Going forward. Wait, before we do that, gotta unlock it. Now we go. I'm obviously forgetting something. So, let's see, I'm in manual mode. Auto, spindles on. There we go. Going up to 3,000. Here, down to 300, excuse me. It maxes out at 5,000, but we're not going there today. So anyway, you get the idea. You can stop the spindle. You can reverse the direction. You can reverse it on the fly. So there you go, Jesse. I hope that helps you. It won't be long before you get yours here. So you are correct, Mark Lindsay. These kinds of things only happen when shows are live. So
I'm going to go and play with this some more, and I hope you get a chance to enter the giveaway. So if you didn't get a chance, I don't know what more I could do. I've told you about it on the podcast. I told you about it on live, and you've seen it in the Facebook group. Somebody's going to win. I hope it's you.